In 1947, a young man fresh from the rigors of World War II and a year out of Temple University took Horace Greeley's words to heart and went west. Dave Young stepped off the train in Wyoming, where he finished his schooling at the University of Wyoming, graduating in 1951 with a Bachelor of Science degree in communications. He prepared himself well for a future in broadcasting. While still at the university, Dave took jobs as a department store Santa Claus, a home appliance repairman, and even had a stint in the paleontology lab cleaning the bones of dinosaurs. Some men seek the meaning of life climbing to the mountaintop. Dave sought it deep in the bowels of a lead mine where he worked with his brothers. It was here that Dave had his first encounter with an alternative means of transportation. What's more natural in Wyoming than horses? Nothing. So Dave sought one out. Unfortunately, Dave was unaware that the breaking in period for a new horse was slightly different from the breaking in period for a new car. Now Dave was a real Westerner. He had his horse. He worked in the mines and even did his share of cooking on an old cast iron stove. He was ready for broadcasting. After graduating, Dave went to work for KFBC Radio in Cheyenne and moved to Sydney, Nebraska in 1954 to manage KSID, a station that had been on the air for only 2 years. Dave must have liked it. He stayed with KSID until May of 1986 and saw the station grow into a powerful and influential voice in western Nebraska. KSID has followed its Sydney teams to many state championships to provide information to its listeners. Dave became an active member of the Sydney community, working on school bond elections, the Sydney City Council, and a variety of civic organizations. The Youngs spent many summer weekends at their home on Lake McConaughey, boating and water skiing. Dave and his charming wife, Ibs, have 4 children. The Youngs boast of being proud Nebraskans with a deep sense of community pride. David Young has been with the Nebraska Broadcasters Association for many years. He served as its vice president in 1957 and as president in 1958. With his help, our organization has grown, and we are deeply grateful to him.